Fondly known by many as the greatest show on earth, where men, women and children of all ages are invited to witness spectacular, daring and incredible acts that reach beyond their wildest imagination. The modern circus is a worldwide phenomenon and has brought happiness and joy to countless of people throughout its existence. The circus has also changed the lives of thousands and has had a significant impact on today's global society. Throughout this documentary, we will be speaking to some established names within the industry and members of the general public to find out how the circus began, what made the circus so popular, and finally, why the circus industry is not as popular today as it once was. The modern circus was created in England by former Cavalry Sergeant Major Philip Astley, who has since become known as the father of modern circus.
He was an officer in the Royal Dragoon Regiment in London, and he used to give demonstrations of horse riding in fields and parks around that wonderful city. And people used to stand around and watch.
Astley's public demonstrations became so popular that by 1770, Astley decided that he needed to bring some novelty to his performances. Consequently, he hired the likes of acrobats, rope dancers and jugglers, interspersing their acts between his equestrian displays.
Because in the old days, in the variety, they used to have aerial acts and acrobatic acts, and he combined the two, so he had the whole show with the variety shows.
The name circus was derived from the Latin word for circle, due to the circular centerpiece, which would later become known as the ring.
And it reduced the big area he used to ride around on to a small circus ring.
Astley's famous amphitheatre consisted of a ring design, which allowed the audience to keep sight of the riders and performers at all times. Riding in circles also made it possible, through the generation of centrifugal force, for riders to keep their balance while standing on the back of galloping horses. As the years went on, the circus industry began to become increasingly popular.
And that's why it all progressed from there, and it just grew and grew and grew. It was a great form of entertainment and people loved it.
Not only in England, but all across the world. As the circus is essentially a visual performing art, it was therefore unfettered by language barriers and enjoyed worldwide. To get a better understanding of how the circus industry has changed people's lives, we came to the British seaside resort known as Blackpool, home to the famous Blackpool Tower Circus, which has been open to the public since May 1894. Undoubtedly, one of the greatest success stories from the Blackpool Tower Circus was a clown known as Charlie Cairoli.
My father, Charlie Cairoli, he worked at the Blackpool Tower for 40 years. He was a big part of the Blackpool Tower, and he was in Blackpool Tower in its sort of heyday type of things after during the war.
Italian-born Charlie Cairoli began his performing career at the age of 7 years old. Born into a travelling circus, Charlie lived his entire life within the shows. He also met his wife, Violetta Fratellini, who was from a circus family known as the Fratellini Clowns. Together they had three children.
Having a clown as a father is quite weird, actually, because I think I said before, he was a great practical joker. He loved children, because children were honest with you. Kids, if you're not funny, kids will turn around and say, "You're not funny." You know, there's no one. Adults will go, "Oh, you're really good this year, Charlie." They walk away saying it was bloody awful. You know what I mean? But kids tell you as it is.
There's nothing nicer than to be in a packed tower circus, Charlie having the audience rocking, and him and I would have some little in-jokes. But because we were both established, the audience used to fall about.
Just a minute. Charlie, take the earphones off. What do you think you're doing? You've spoiled the show already.
Hey, you got the funny face.
And where's my caption?
Cut to Norman's caption.
Hey, okay. Just a minute.
To me, he was a great dad. A great practical joker. Except when he was doing his income tax, that was it. He was miserable getting them. When I worked with him, he played some because I first started, I did my time as an engineer, and then on This Is Your Life in 1969, I asked him if I could join him. He said yes, so I joined him in 1970. And he would put, I don't know if you lads know it, but stuff you could put on your nails to stop you biting your nails. Well, he would put that on my clarinet reed. So when I had to start playing it, take it off.
I went in one day, I had to walk in, grab Charlie by the lapels, say to him, I've stood enough of your nonsense. And this particular day, he'd found a dead fly in the dressing room and stuck it on the end of his nose. So as I grabbed him, I said, I've stood up. And we just both went into hysterics. And the nice thing about it, the audience knew we were having fun and they laughed along with us. Our great, great days, great days.
Charlie quickly became an international phenomenon and throughout his circus career performed for the likes of Queen Elizabeth II, Princess Diana, and in one performance in 1939, Adolf Hitler appeared at the Circus Krone in Munich, who afterward presented Charlie with a watch.
We did a show for Princess Diana. We'd just done the custard pie routine and she came walking because it was all these children with hearing problems. So they wanted a visual act and we had this big custard pie left. And we stood there and she walked on and we looked at it. You could hear the cameras going. Somebody was waiting for us to sort of pie Princess Diana. And she looked at it, it was me and Stu Francis, and she said, it's more than your life's worth. So it does open many doors and you just work with really nice people as well. So, you know, Bobby Davro, he was another, who else? Mick Jagger came to see the show when I was in the circus because he's a big circus fan, Mick Jagger. Loves the circus.
This shows that not only was the circus industry exclusively popular to the working class, but it appealed to a much more wider demographic, spanning over many different walks of life. Charlie Cairoli was legendary within the UK, but he was one of many who had their lives changed by the circus industry. Also living in Blackpool is ex-professional trapeze artist Jose Torralba. Born in Colombia, he followed his dream and performed in circuses all across the world.
Circus to me is life. Circus is the most beautiful thing ever happens to me. I love the circus. Circus is beautiful. Well, the circus came to my hometown and I went with a few friends and we go under the tent, we sneak around and go back and we sit down and watch the show. And that was the most beautiful thing I ever seen in my life. And then the circus left and my uncle was a clown. He was working in another circus. So they come back like 6-7 months later and I tell him I want to be in the circus.
Jose spent over 40 years working in the circus. During this time, he gained experience working within many different aspects of the industry.
When I started in the circus, I remember the first time I started delivering water to the caravans, to the performers. And from there, I started selling sweets. And then I used to watch the clowns all the time. And I said to my uncle, I want to be a clown. So he said, yeah, so okay. Let's start practicing. And I start practicing with him, and then I become a clown. And I worked like about seven, 8 months in Central America. And then a big circus came, Hermanos Fuentes Gasca, and he saw all the clowns and he liked me. So he says, hey, you want to work for me? I said, yeah, why not? And the owner used to tell me all the time, why you don't be a performer? I said, oh no, because the clowns to me is everything. I love to be a clown. He said, but you're young, you're a good looking guy, you can be a good performer. So I said, okay, so I started practicing. It was in my case every day. I said, okay. I started practicing. And I started doing the wire, I started doing the trampoline, tumble. Then one day we're going to see this, the circus movie, Trapeze. And when I saw that movie, I fell in love with the trapeze. I said, oh, that's what I want to be. Then I start practicing every day the trapeze. And I come to trapeze artist and I left to America to work in Ringley Brothers, the great show on earth.
Jose's almost lifelong career within the industry allowed him to achieve his dream of becoming a professional trapeze artist. The circus allowed Jose to meet and perform for figures such as Paul McCartney and former US President Ronald Reagan. However, Jose learned in one incident that working as a professional trapeze artist can be a very dangerous career.
Well, I was working in New Jersey in the Great Invention Park, and we was doing the show, and I do a 2.5 somersault, and the catcher grabbed me by my legs. The net is 30 feet high, so I passed the net from the top straight to the floor, and I was almost three months out of work. I dislocated my hand, I cut my face, my eye was open. I got 14 stitches outside, 7 inside, and my knees bruised because they hit the ground. And that was the biggest accident I ever have. So I can't wait to get back again and start practicing. And I go back again and I did it.
Jose's passion and commitment to the circus has continued throughout his life. Today, Jose runs his own circus school in Blackpool, named the Circus Academy, where he teaches a variety of different circus acts, such as trampoline, trapeze, and juggling.
With the history of Blackpool with the circus, I think we have the opportunity to give something back to our community. I love the circus and I love to teach. It's something I really enjoy. And seeing the kid grow the confidence when they go into the trapeze or when they go into the trampoline, it's something really excites me and I love it. So that's what we're running the Circus Academy.
Jose Torralba is yet another example of someone who has had their lives changed by the circus industry and who aims to now change the lives of the next generation with the traditional value of the circus. But the question arises, will the traditional value of the circus be as successful in modern society as it once was? To get a better understanding, we travel to the capital of England, London, the birthplace of modern circus, and spoke to who many call the world's greatest ringmaster, Norman Barrett, who currently works within the Zippos Circus and holds the Guinness World Record for the longest career as a ringmaster.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the greatest show on earth.
My name is Norman Barrett. I'm the ringmaster at the Zippos Circus. I've been in show business all my life. I spent 25 years as ringmaster at the Tower Circus. So I've been around a little bit.
Please welcome your host for tonight, your ringmaster, Mr. Norman Barrett.
Thank you very much indeed. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a gala performance of the Circus World Championships.
Norman Barrett has performed in countless of circuses throughout his life, and it would all have not been possible without his father.
He was a farmer, sold the farm, joined the circus, so I was actually born into the circus. Then he ran his own circus. Unfortunately, he died, and then I went out and working around. And I first started out with a dog act, then I became a very bad clown. And the lady that was running the circus, Kitty Roberts, said, "You're a terrible clown, but you would make a good ringmaster." So she is the person I have to thank for her making me into a ringmaster.
Norman currently works for the Zippos Circus. As we were filming, the Zippos Circus were beginning their annual tour across the UK.
I'm Dave Hibling. I'm the creative director for Zippos Circus. My job is every year to conceive the programme, choreograph it, put it together, choose the running order, create the production numbers, sort the lighting out, and create the show that goes on the road for the next 7 months.
Well, this we have the motorbikes in the globe.
I like the motorbike.
We have a very good handstand girl from Bulgaria.
We enjoyed the acrobatics most, actually. Thought it was really, really good fun.
We have the clowns come from Italy, the Rastelli, world famous musical clowns. We have the horses, some are under her Arabian stallions, and a big horse and a little pony. The budgies are there. Then there's jugglers, a gentleman on the trapeze, a young lady that does a trapeze act on an umbrella. Yeah, I think, is he up there now? It might be, I don't think it might be up there, yeah. So it's all varied, you see, and as I said before, you're all looking at different acts. So you're not, people that sit in the seats aren't going to like every act, but as long as they enjoy 80% of them, and you're winning because it's all personal choice. We can kind of go and have a meal. You might like the meal, I might not like it, or it's all personal choice.
Norman even has his own act within the circus, which he has been performing for almost 50 years. The act involves very familiar animals, the budgies.
You know how you tell the difference between a male and female? These are all male birds, actually. And the top of the beach, the sir, if that is blue, then a male bird. It's harder to tell if it's a female. That is a male bird as well. But the other way to find out if it's a male bird, if you shake it like that and it rattles, it's a male bird. The opportunities it's given me to tour the world. I've been to America for 2 years, Israel, all doing what I like to do and doing the tourist bit as well. Yeah, I've been around, I've met so many people. You know, I was graciously honoured by Her Majesty, the MBE. So that's all things that have happened through me doing my job.
Norman's career in the circus has truly changed his life. A man who loved the circus so much that he refuses to let go of his dream career. The circus industry has not just changed the lives of thousands, but it has also had a cultural impact, and conventions of the circus industry have been utilised within other industries such as media, music and theatre.
Be careful.
Rest your hand close to my heart, never to part, baby of mine.
However, over the previous years, it has become quite evident that the circus industry has become increasingly less popular. To get a better understanding of the many contributing factors behind the circus industry's recent decline in today's society, we also spoke to members of the public to find out what the circus now means to them and, more importantly, why they think the circus is not as popular as it once was.
Maybe it's just out of fashion more than anything else.
Maybe years ago there was the only thing that people could do to like have fun or something. Now there are plenty of other things.
So I think the circus does have an old feel to it, doesn't it? Of a bygone time. And things have moved on so much, entertainment is so much faster and different now that people have got short attention spans in the circus. I think it takes a bit of time to go down and visit and engage with.
I suppose it's got to be the press. Obviously, with like animal rights violations and how the animals are treated, it's put people off.
Well, TV. There's no TV media as such. When was the last time? It used to be on the television, regular Blackpool Tower Circus, but it's not on anymore. There's all these X Factor and all this rubbish, and there's not.
I think there's just so much other things to do, you know.
I just think it's animal cruelty. Like some people are like against seeing animals entertain people and things, like that kind of thing. But yeah.
I mean, when I was younger, I really did like it. It was a fun thing to go to. You know, you're with your friends and there's animals doing tricks, so it's cool. But I realized that I'm old because I'm older. That the way they treat animals, like, it's just cruel, and they don't like deserve that kind of treatment. They shouldn't be locked up their whole lives. They should be out in the wild, and yeah.
Probably because it's more expensive and stuff.
I don't really like the circus because once a horse dropped dead during the actual performance.
As you can see, there are a variety of opinions within the public as to why the industry is not as popular. But what do the people who have worked in the industry have to say?
Circus industry has changed over the years for many different reasons. I mean, I'm going back to the 1920s when my father started, with no television. Life is a wheel. The wheel turns round. Fashion. You know, fashion starts there, then it goes right down, and then it changes all the way. Then the same fashion, maybe in 10 years, comes back. You know, and it's the same with circus has had a bad time when television's, well, going back when talkies first started, circus went right to the bottom. Then circus came up again, And then television came in and it went down again. And now, and it's coming up again because people realise it's good, clean, exciting family entertainment. You know, we are getting more teenagers than ever before come into the circus.
Well, I think the circus industry is not popular as it used to be because of television. It was like music hall and things like that. People would go out and go out to the show and dress up and things like that. Now you sit at home and watch television. There's such a vast viewership problems on television that people don't have to go out anymore. Whereas circuses, you went out, you had the big parade, posters and people said, oh, we'll go see the circus. And also with television, if you had an act, once it's on television, everybody's seen it. So you either got to try and get something else. So a lot of people didn't want to do television. So, yeah, television. Love it, but hate it at the same time.
Well, the circus is not that popular like before because we have the problem now, the internet and television. Television took a lot from the circus because people used to go, when the circus came to town, that was a big celebration. Everybody used to go into the circus. People still love the circus. I mean, the grandpa and the new generation, they're always telling the stories about the circus, the excitement, the animals. That's, you know, one of the problems. We lose the animals in the circus, and that was a big attraction to draw the people to the circus because it's not the exciting. I mean, the only places you can see the animals is in the zoo, but not every town has a zoo. So we bring the circus, bring the animals to every town, and the excitement of the kids, and they love it, and that changed everything. They make, you know, losing the animals and television and internet, so everything goes down. But the circus is still going on. The circus never dies. As long as we have kids, we will have circus.
Based on a survey that we have conducted, the majority of the public believe that the main reason for the circus industry's decline is due to the controversy surrounding animal rights. So the question arises, should circuses have animals?
As long as they're looked after, I think it's okay. As long as they're properly looked after. But if they're not properly looked after, then they shouldn't be allowed to be put in a circus.
Yes, they should have animals because of the traditions behind it, but they could do with treating them better.
I think they probably should still have animals. That was part of the reason why I, as a kid, wanted to go to see the circus. I didn't go for the human performance. I went to see the animals, the lions and the elephants and things like that. So I think they should, but I certainly think there should be more control about how those animals are looked after.
If they treat them well, but if they don't, then no.
It's not really fair. I don't know how well they treat them, but I can't imagine that it's that great, honestly. Yeah.
It's a long debate. It's a difficult debate, and there is, of course, a difference between wild and domestic animals. But in my heart of hearts, I honestly believe animals do not suffer in the circus at all, and I would be very sad if the day came when circuses did not have any animals whatsoever.
I don't think so, because animals are not made to be transported around the world in that kind of way in cages, so I don't think so, yeah.
I do believe circuses should have animals because they are an integral part of the circus, because that's what circus is. It's just a variety of acts. There's plenty of room for the animals to work. They do enjoy it. When the horses or elephants hear their music, they'll know their music's coming up because they'll know the act before, and they start getting excited. It's really strange to see because you think they know sort of after that music it's our music, so they start, you can see them getting all excited.
The circus, the animals in the circus has to be trained. You have to practice the animals, and you practice with the animals every day, and you build a relationship with the animal. And you look after the animals. Before we eat, we feed the animal in the circus. But, I mean, you gotta train the animals. You have to use the whip, you have to use the stick, but it's only so they can see it, that, you know, there's a kind of discipline. But not everybody abuses the animals. I see some videos that, you know, some people do, but not everybody do in the circus. And that's my opinion.
I think circuses should have animals, providing they're looked after correctly. Here, the animal husbandry is excellent. We tick all the boxes, but we just only have domesticated animals, horses, dogs, the budgies. I believe providing any animals is looked after correctly, and that's very important. It has to be looked at correctly. Any animal that has given the task to do lives a more fulfilled life. Now, animals in the jungle or in Africa are getting poached all the time. So providing they're looked after properly, and I really mean that, and most people who are in the circus do that, but there's bad apples in every sack.
The debate surrounding animal cruelty and various other controversies that surround the circus industry will likely continue as long as the industry exists. However, if there is one thing that we can agree on, it is that the circus industry is a phenomenon and will continue to influence and change the lives of many new generations. In the words of Norman Barrett, you are never too old, never too young, and never too cool to go to the circus. The greatest show on earth.